Dear students, I am a mathematics faculty from Narayana Group of Educational Institutions. Today I am here to discuss GTA 7 paper 1 mathematics part. Okay, shall we start discussing the paper? Right, we shall start with first question, that is question number 37. It says that K subsets of a set A containing the elements 1, 2, 3 and so on up to n, and k subsets are made out of 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on and n. And the probability that their intersection is, so first option, their probability that their intersection is empty is 1 by 2 whole power n when k equal to 2. And B option says, okay, the probability that the point of that their intersection is 3 by 4 whole power n when k equal to 2. And C option, okay, and intersection is empty is 7 by 8 whole power n when k equal to 3. And singleton set probability is 7 by 8 whole power n minus 1. N when k equal to 3. See, there are k subsets made, and first case when k equal to 2, probability that intersection of both the set is empty. So let us take it A1 as well as what is it, A2. These are the two subsets. Okay, intersection of A1 and A2 must be empty. It means an element taken from A should go to A1 or should go to A2 or it should go back to A only. It should not go to both. Therefore, okay, one element has got a chance. So one element can go to A1 or it can go to A2 or it can go to A1 and A2 or it can go to A1 union A2. That is again going back to A. These are the four possibilities. According to the question, that we need to have, what is that, probability of the intersection is empty. So the element should go to either A1 or A2 or it may go back to A, but not A1 and A2. So one element has got four options, out of which the favorable is only 3. So the probability of getting intersection is empty is 3 by 4 whole power n when k equal to 2. Right, and when k equal to 3, then there are, what is it, 3 subsets are made and their intersection should be empty. So an element chosen from A can go to either A1 or A2 or A3 or A1 and A2 or A1 and A3 or A2 and A3, okay, or A1, A2, A3. It should not be, or it can go back to A. So one element has got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 options, out of which the favorable is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So the probability of getting, okay, intersection to be empty when 3 subsets are made is 7 by 8 whole power n. Out of 8 favorable, total possibilities, 7 are favorable. So 7 by 8 whole power n when k equal to 3, right? Now, this is what is it? This option for singleton set when k equal to 3. When k equal to 3, there are 3 subsets made out of A and intersection has to be a singleton set. That is possible. What is that? Let us choose one element from this n and let it be in all 3. So that can be done by n ways. Remaining n minus 1 elements should not go to all the places. So that will become 7 power n minus 1 by total possibility 8 power n. So that will become n by 8 into 7 by 8 whole power n minus 1. Then this option D cannot be there. So the correct option is B and C. I'll just quickly repeat it. Okay. The A is a given set, and there are three sets made. The question is, find the probability of getting intersection is to be singleton set. That can be done by this method. What is it? I choose one element out of n element and let it be in all three sets. The remaining n minus 1 should not be in all three sets. So it can go to any other all 7 possibility. So 7 power n minus 1. And the total possibility is 8 power n. So it becomes 8 by n by 8 into 7 by 8 whole power n minus 1. So the required answer is n by 8 into 7 by 8 whole power n minus 1. So option D is not right. So the correct options are B and C. Right? Question number 38 says there is a triangle ABC whose position vectors are 2A bar, 3B bar and 2 times A cross B. Also given that OA dot OB equal to minus 3 and also given that mod A equal to 1 and mod B equal to 1. We need to check which of the following options are incorrect. It's given that first option is ABC is a triangle which is right angled. We have to check whether it is right angle triangle or not. So for that, I'll use the given condition first. OA dot OB equal to minus 3, which implies 2A dot 3B equal to minus 3, which implies A dot B equal to minus 1 by 2. Let it be. Now we are going to find out angle C. Let me find out. To find out angle C, I will go for finding CB bar dot CA bar. What is CB bar? That is nothing but 2A cross B minus 3B bar dot 2A cross B minus 2A bar. That is, using distributive law, I will just multiply. This is going to be 4 times A cross B whole square. Here when you multiply, this becomes 0. This becomes 0. And this will become plus 6 times A dot B. Using the given condition A dot B equal to minus 1 by 2, then this will become minus 3. And A cross B we need to find out. How do you find out? Okay, we know that A cross B whole square plus A dot B whole square equal to mod A square mod B square. Here mod A square mod B square 1. So this is going to be 1. And A dot B whole square, A dot B already we calculated 1 by 2, minus 1 by 2. Square it, minus 1 by 4 this side. So A cross B whole square will be 3 by 4. Right? So this part I am going to use it here. So this is going to be 4 into 3 by 4. Cancel. So 0. It means, okay, dot product of CB bar and CA bar gives you 0. Therefore angle C is 90. Right? So first option is correct. But they are asking you to mark it incorrect option. So option A will not be. So now second option given is the position vector of the orthocenter of the triangle ABC lies outside the triangle. Since the given triangle is right angle triangle, orthocenter will be one of the vertex, that is C. So option B is incorrect. Now option C, they are asking you to calculate cos A value. For finding cos A value, I will go for finding the sides. Whether it is required or not, I will just go for finding. To find out that side AB, what I will go? AB equal to mod of 2A bar minus 3B bar. That is AB square I will go for. Right? So that is nothing but 4A square. Mod A square 1 plus, right, 3B whole square. That is 9B square 1. So minus, here what do you know, 6 times A dot B. A dot B we have got minus 1 by 2. Cancel out. 3. So this is going to be 13. And here what is that? Minus minus plus. That is 16. So AB becomes what is that? 4. Similarly, AC also I will go for finding. That is AC square equal to mod of 2A cross B minus 2A whole square. This is equal to 4 times A cross B whole square plus 4. Into mod A square, that is 1, and 2 times 2a bar dot, this will become 0. So 4 a cross b whole square also we calculated, that is nothing but 3 by 4 a cross b whole square, 3 by 4 plus here what is now 4, cancel out 7. So ac will become what is it, root 7. And similarly we will find out for what is now bc square, that is 2 times a cross b minus 3b whole square, that is nothing but 4 times a cross b whole square, already 3 by 4 plus 9 b square 1, and 2 times this dot this become 0, so again cancelled, what is it, this is going to be 12, then bc will become 2 root 3. Now we can easily go for finding the angle a as well as angle b, whatever you need you can go for. So the correct options are a and c, but they are asking you to find out incorrect, they are b and c. Done? Which is conducted on 22nd March 2020. I'm going to discuss now question number 39, right? It says that solution of the differential equation that is given, x minus 3 x cube y square into dy minus y plus x square into y cube into dx equal to 0. Right? Is f of x comma y equal to 0, and given that f of 1 comma 1 is 0. So we shall first find out that solution of the differential equation, that is nothing but x dy, I'll just rearrange them, minus y dx one side. The remaining terms are 3x cube y square into dy, and here minus, that is plus x square y cube into dx. So here what I am observing is number 3, here there is no 3. So this may be the differentiation of y cube, and here there is no 3. So I will take out this x square outside. Then this will become 3 times x into y square dy plus y cube into dx. So this can be written as x square into d of x into y cube, I can write it. And again this x square I will bring this side. So this will become now x square, here x into dy minus y into dx. This is nothing but d of y by x. Now this is d of x y cube. Now integrate both sides with respect to x. Y by x equal to x y cube plus some c. Right? Now we will use the given condition to find out c value. 1 comma 1 is 0. So this will become, what is that, 1 comma 1, that will put 1 on 1 will get cancelled, c will be 0. So the required function is y by x equal to x into y cube, or y equal to x square into y cube, right? So which implies we will get two solutions. One is y equal to 0, or another solution is y square equal to 1 by x square, or y equal to plus or minus 1 by x. So there are three functions satisfying the given condition. That is y equal to 0, or y equal to 1 by x, or y equal to minus 1 by x. Now we shall look into the options. That what are the options? Okay, see, there will be one point of intersection with the solution of the differential equation and the curve x square plus y square equal to r square when r equal to 0, and two solutions when r equal to 1, and six solutions when r equal to root 2, and 10 solutions when r equal to 2. These are the four options. So what I will do it is, okay, option A I will choose it. When r equal to 0, this is nothing but, what is it, just a point. and we have got the solution of the differential equation is y equal to 0 or y equal to 1 by x or y equal to minus 1 by x. So in this case we will get only one point of intersection. So option A is right. Next, option B, what does it say? Two points if r equal to 1. If I put r equal to 1, the circle is like this, that is x square plus y square equal to 1, right? Now the solution of the differential equations are y equal to 0, y equal to plus or minus 1 by x. So y equal to 0 here comes, so here you will get two points of intersections. And y equal to 1 by x, remember y equal to 1 by x and x square plus y square equal to 1 equal to 1. They will not intersect. They will not intersect. This is y equal to 1 by x. Another curve y equal to minus 1 by x also will not intersect with the circle when radius is 1. So the required number of point of intersection is only 2. So option B also right. Option C says, option C, when r equal to root 2, that is the circle x square plus y square equal to what is that, 2. In this case, this is a circle, okay, radius is root 2. In this case, the curve y equal to 0, so you will get two solutions. And y equal to 1 by x will exactly touch the circle. Y equal to 1 by x will exactly touch the circle. And y equal to minus 1 by x exactly touch the circle at one point. And y equal to minus 1 by x here. So the point of intersection 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in this case. So option C also right. Right? Option D says there are 10 points if r equal to 2. So when r equal to 2, the circle is x square plus y square equal to 4. In this case, y equal to 1 by x will intersect at 2 points and below x axis also 2 points, and then y equal to minus 1 by x will intersect circle at 2 points and here also 2 points. And there is another solution y equal to 0 that will get another two more solutions. So total 10 solutions, right? So option A, B, C, D, all are right, correct? I am going to discuss now question number 40, shall we? Yes. The question says f of x is equal to x cube plus x plus 1. And p of x is another polynomial and which is monic. It means coefficient of the leading coefficient is 1. So p of x is a cubic monic polynomial such that roots of p of x is equal to 0 are the squares of the roots of f of x is equal to 0. Then all the options are related to p of x. So first let me find out p of x. So it's given that roots of f of x are suppose alpha, beta, gamma. And p of x is a cubic monic polynomial whose roots are alpha square, beta square and gamma square. So to find out this, I'll go for finding sigma alpha square. Sigma alpha square. For that, I'll use the given condition that alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to some of the roots here. Is what is at 0 and some of the roots taken 2 at a time, okay, equal to 1 and alpha beta gamma equal to minus 1. Using that result, sigma alpha square can be easily found out, so which can be done by yourself. I'll just write it directly, minus 2. And similarly, sigma alpha square into beta square, this also can be calculated using that statement, that is going to be 1. And again, product of alpha square, beta square, gamma square also. So that is nothing but directly visible, that is 1. So now p of x will become x cube, because leading coefficient is 1, because given condition is monic cubic polynomial. And sigma alpha square is minus 2, so plus 2x square. Now, and the sigma alpha square beta square is 1. So plus 6 and minus 1. So here what did I do? It is to find out p of x. I just calculated some of the roots taken one at a time, two at a time, three at a time, and then I framed the third degree polynomial. Now we will answer for the questions. Because we got the p of x, no? What is the question? First number option, p of 4 is divisible by 11. P of 4. P of 4, I'll calculate it. That is 64 plus 32 plus 4 minus 1. So what is that? 99. So it is divisible by 11. So option A is right. Option B, the last two digits of P of 1 whole power 50. P of 1 whole power 50. The last two digits we need to find out. What is P of 1? Let's put 1. 1, 2, 1, minus 1. That is nothing but 4 minus 1, 3. Okay, 3, 4, minus 1, so 3. This is nothing but 3 power 50. When it is divided by 100, what is the remainder? That's what we need to calculate it. That's what they are saying, that last two digits. That we can easily calculate it. That is coming out to be 49. That is coming out to be 49. So given option is 99. So option B cannot be right. Again, option C is when P of 1 whole power 50 is divided by 5, the remainder is 1. It's not possible because here the remainder is going to be, the last two digits is 49, no? So the remainder is going to be 4. So option C also not right. Now let us come to option D. That is the probability that P of n is an odd integer is 0.5. I'll go for finding P of n. What is P of n? That is n cube plus 2 times n square plus n minus 1. The probability that P of n is odd integer. Suppose n is odd. If n is odd, this is going to be odd. This is going to be even. This is going to be odd minus 1. Odd minus 1 is even. Even plus even is even. Even plus odd is odd. Right? Suppose n is even. Suppose n is even. Then this is going to be even cube. Even. This is again going to be even. This is going to be even minus 1. Even minus 1 is what? Odd. Right? Even plus odd is odd. Again, even plus odd is odd. So P of n is always going to be odd. So the probability cannot be 0.5. So the correct option is only A. Right? We shall now discuss question number 41. Right? Question number 41 says that equation 3 sine theta plus 4 cos theta equal to 5 times x square plus ax plus 1 for some theta and x belongs to R has real solution, then A can take what are the possible values. See here, observe the question that left hand side there is an expression in terms of trigonometry, right hand side there is an expression in terms of x, that is quadratic expression, that variable is x and here the variable is theta. As theta varies, it lies between minus 5 to 5 and there is here x. Here x and theta are totally independent variable, so it may take minus 5 to 5, so for that x can take any value, x square plus ax plus 1. So what I am trying to say is this side variable is theta, that side variable is x and here a is involved, all three are independent. So a may take any value. So the options a, b, c, d, anything can be true. So the correct answer is a, b, c, d. Right? I am going to now discuss question number 42. Right? Question number 42 says that A, B, C are distinct cube roots of 1. and the determinant given A minus C, A minus B, B minus C, B, B minus A, and C minus B, C minus A, and C equal to lambda. We need to find out the value of mod lambda. Yes. I'll observe the question that determinant A minus C, A minus B, B minus C, B, B minus A, this is there. See, we need to simplify the determinant. So what you observe that, suppose if I go for adding C1 and C2, what is going to be A plus B minus C, A plus B minus C, here it's going to be 0. So there is something common that we can take it out. So I'll go for C1 tends to C1 plus C2. Once again, I'll tell C1 plus C2. So what is going to be coming out of A plus B minus C will be coming out. Then here it will become 1, here 1, here 0. Right? Again, C2 and C3 observed. So C2 and C3, this will become 0. Here it will become B plus C minus A. This will become B plus C minus A. So again, I'll take it B plus C minus A. I'll take it outside. That is, I am applying this column transformation. So then again it's going to be 0, 1, 1. Now let the third column be. Okay. Now it's easy to simplify. Now 1 into C, here what is that? Minus C plus A. Here again 0. Here 1 into C minus B. Again, what is going to be? That is B plus C minus A, A plus B minus C into what is going to be? Okay, A plus C minus B. This is what the value of the determinant. And given that ABC are distinct cube roots of 1, therefore A plus B plus C equal to 0. So in the place of B plus C, I can write it, what is that? Minus A. In the place of A plus B, I can write it, what is the minus C. In the place of A plus C, I can write it minus B. So when I go for multiplying all those things, it's going to be minus 2A into minus 2C into minus 2B. So the lambda is now, what is that? Or mod lambda, I'll write it. Mod of A times ABC. But ABC is, what is that? 1. Because ABC are the cube roots of 1. So the answer is going to be, what is it? 8. What is the question that is asked? Mod lambda is greater than. Option A is 0, option B is 2, option C is 4, option D is 8. So mod lambda greater than 0, 2, 4. So the correct answer is A, B, C. Right? Today we are going to discuss GTA 7 paper 1, which is conducted on 22nd March of 2020. We are now going to discuss question number 43. Dear students, I am a mathematics faculty from Narayana Group of Educational Institutions. Today I am going to discuss GTA 7. Paper 1, which is conducted on 22nd March 2020. I am now going to discuss question number 43. Shall we? Right. The question says number of points of intersection of the two curves given is cos of x minus y equal to 1 and cos of x plus y equal to 1 by 3. Right? So that question is number of points of intersection and where x comma y belongs to minus pi to pi. So this equation is very easy, that is cos of x minus y equal to 1. So x minus y can be either 0 or x minus y can be 2 pi or x minus y can be minus 2 pi. Right? These are the three possibilities. Right? And cos of x plus y equal to 1 by 3. So let me draw the graph of cos of x plus y. And since x and y belongs to minus pi to pi, x plus y may vary from minus 2 pi to 2 pi. So cos of something, that graph I'll draw. Okay, it will be like this. This is pi by 2, this is pi. And this is, what is it, again going up. This is 2 pi. And similarly here also. Okay. So the graph will be like this. And the cos of something equal to 1 by 3. So 1 by 3 may be somewhere here. There will be 1, 2, 3, 4 solutions. Okay. So let me take, this is some theta. And then this will be 2 pi minus theta. If this is, what is it, minus theta. If this is theta, then this must be minus theta. Then this will be, what is this? This is minus 2 pi. So this will be minus 2 pi plus theta. So these are the four solutions. So possibilities, x plus y equal to theta, x plus y equal to minus theta, and the x plus y equal to 2 pi minus theta, and the x plus y equal to minus 2 pi plus theta. So here we have three sets, here we have got four. So then, given that x comma y belongs to minus pi to pi, and they are asking you to find out number of points of intersection of these two graph, number of pairs of x comma y. So now here 3, here 4. So all together 12, but all the 12 will not be satisfying. For example, now x minus y equal to 2 pi. This is possible only when x is pi and y is minus pi. And that will not be satisfying any of the things. And x minus y equal to minus 2 pi. That is possible when x equal to minus pi and y equal to pi. That is also will not satisfy anything. So the only thing is x minus y equal to 0 will work with all four options. So the correct answer is only 4. 4 pairs of x comma y will satisfy both the equations. Done? Right.